Thank you, Carol Costello. Hi, everybody. Nice to have you with us. It's 11 o'clock on the East Coast, 8 o'clock on the West Coast, and here's where we begin. An alarming new development this morning over Muslim outrage all over the world against that anti-Islam film, and just when it appeared that maybe those violent protests might be receding, a French satirical magazine has come out with cartoons today, cartoons that mock the Prophet Muhammad. We've got the magazine here. We can't show the images, but I'll tell you what. Look at the offices. It's the same place where these offices were damaged in a firebomb last year over an issue that appeared to make fun of Islamic law. At this point today, we are not aware of any major violence that has broken out, but the French government, while at the same time protecting free speech, is condemning the magazine's decision to publish the cartoons, and it's also taking steps to protect French citizens and its embassies. Our Jim Bitterman is live with us now in Paris. So, Jim, give us a bit of a feel, because you're later in the day than we are here on the East Coast of the United States. Has this gone over quieter than expected? Are we expecting protests? Where do things stand?
Well, I think it's quiet up till now. Obviously, the French government is worried about things, and they're particularly worried about the idea that something might happen on Friday, because they have closed down embassies and French embassies and French schools in 20 different countries where they think there could be a problem as of Friday, and they're not going to reopen again until Monday. Now, of course, all during the day today, there's been a lot of official reaction. The Islamic community, for example, had a council meeting, and they complained before the press about how this was outrageous and should never have been allowed to happen. There was a request, by the way, late last night to block the publication of the magazine in question, but the government refused. The government's been saying that they condemn the magazine as well, but they say, look, this is freedom of expression. And the magazine itself has been reacting, and they've been saying, look, we're just doing what we always do. We're outrageous. We know we're outrageous. And this is what we do for a living. I talked to one of the cartoonists for the magazine, one of 12 cartoonists. He's been under security protection 24 hours a day since last November, when the magazine's offices were torched back then. He seemed even a little bit surprised at the kind of reaction that he saw. Here's what he said.
There was a big fire of French paranoia from the media that link us to put us into the top of the news just right now. For the moment, it's just a big deal built by the media.
And just to give you an idea how the magazine's sales have been affected, they're practically sold out of the various news kiosks around town. It's not a very big magazine. They only print about 75,000 copies each week, and it's just about sold out as it is now. Ashley?
So, Jim, that was my next question. Was this an effort just to pump up sales? Was this an effort to truly make a worldwide statement? How is it being consumed there among, say, the non-Muslims? Are French people outraged, angry, or nonplussed?
I think it's kind of divided. People have come down both ways on this issue. We were out in the streets with the camera talking to some people, and that's exactly the kind of thing we heard. Some people were for it, some people against it. The thing that has to be understood is that this magazine, every single week, tries to be outrageous. It takes the news headlines and then satirizes them. And in this case, the last week, the news headlines were devoted to the outrage in the world over that film that was released that caused the torching of the embassy in Libya and the deaths in Libya. So this was an attempt to satirize those events. And of course, it's once again causing a kind of firestorm as far as reaction is concerned, actually.
Jim Bitterman for us live in Paris today. Thank you for that, Jim.